Ha 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 ha!
Quit it!
Hey there, singers. Trace here for DNews. I have a love-hate relationship with karaoke. If I am not in a costume at a crappy bar, it's kind of tough to get me in there. But when I do go, some people ruin it by trying to sing well, and some people make it awesome by caterwauling their way through Meatloaf's discography. But whatever. Some people are better singers than others, but it's no different than some people being better runners, ball players, guitarists, or good writers. According to William Bennard's 1967 book, Singing, The Mechanism and Technique, singing is not a natural skill, but an art. Singing is very mechanical. There's much to be said about the shape of a skull, the resonance of the space in the nasal cavity, and how much air can be pushed out of the chest. But let's come back to that, since we're not really talking just about singing, but about singing well. And mechanics are only going to get you so far. They also need to hear the music and then understand it. What musicians call pitch, scientists call frequency. Sound frequency is a measure of the wave oscillations of that sound per second. It's measured in hertz. Having good pitch requires the ears to pick up a precise frequency, the brain to recognize the minute differences in hertz, and then direct the vocal cords to reproduce that sound. From there, the brain has to hear what's coming out and then tweak it ever so slightly and constantly. It sounds difficult, but to be honest, it just takes practice to match pitch. Musicians nail that down through practice, but in a study by the University of Montreal, about 1/5 of non-musicians they tested couldn't control their vocal muscles very well, and 35% couldn't match their voice to a note. But both musicians and non-musicians were able to listen to and match a pitch using a slide instrument. Only 5% couldn't hear the difference in pitch. When the physical is taken out, it would seem 95% of people's brains get pitch. A study in PLOS One took functional MRI scans of brain activity while people listened to and created music. And they compared musical processing to analyzing visual information. You need memory, you need context, you need pattern recognition. But when it comes to music, it uses the speech center. But it also uses other parts of the brain, and they light up too when they're looking for contour, for pitch encoding, and production. More research is needed to find out how these connections can influence musical ability, but again, it is possible to develop this with practice. According to the founder of New York vocal coaching, Justin Stoney, training our voice is similar to going to the gym and training any other muscle. So, to get back to mechanical things and, you know, break some little hearts, yes, some musicality is inborn. Human song vocalization is a big part of our cultural social development. Groups of humans sing together to bond, worship, celebrate, and just for fun. This means social groups that valued singing may have looked for musical characteristics in their mates throughout history. This is supported by a study in the Journal of Medical Genetics, which linked mutations on chromosomes 4Q22 and 8Q13-21 to musical ability. Further studies have found that these genes can influence perception, memory, and even participation in music. Funnily enough, though, 8Q13 has also been linked to dyslexia. Mechanically speaking, a singer is like a piano or a guitar. The same piano strings on a different instrument would sound different because of manufacturing or stress, humidity, the type of wood, and so on and so forth. Every instrument and every person is also different. Women and men have sex differences in their voice box, and people of different genetic backgrounds tend to have different sized nasal cavities and different sized skulls. There are people whose chest cavities and physiological structures are just more beneficial to singing ability. And on top of that, as reported by Medical News Daily, being raised in an encouraging or musical environment will affect your confidence, inherent skill levels and interests, and ultimately, of course, abilities, not unlike any other sports or physical activity. Maybe that's why we see so many singers from churches become singers in the music business. But what do you think? Why are some people better singers, practice or providence? Also, for the opposite of singing, check out this great video explaining what the heck is vocal fry. Like a brass instrument's mouthpiece, vocal cords alone just create a buzzing sound. But if you put a resonator above it, like a horn, you can affect a sound. You get it. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Please come back soon and subscribe.